In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create a text field with animated labels that look like this. When you hover over to the text field, you notice that the border shows a hover effect. And when you click on it, you can see that there is an animated effect that moves the text within the text input up to the top border over here. So let's see how you can build that step by step on Figma. So to create text input field with the animated label, we first need to make use of the text. Create a text here. You can type something like name. Okay, let me just zoom in a little bit so it's clearer. This is a name text. I'm gonna right click on it, and then I'm gonna do a add auto layout. Okay, for this frame, I'm gonna call it text input. All right. Now, the next thing I'd like to do is to give it a white background. Click on fill, give it a white background, and let's just drag it and make it a little bit just slightly longer like this. Okay. Now you can see that the content is align center. We'd like to change it to align left. Okay. The next thing I'd like to do is to change the border radius. Zoom in a little bit. The border radius now is still a little bit sharp, from 0px to 4px. So that looks a little bit softer. Okay. Now it looks a little bit better. Okay. Now I would also like to give it a border. Maybe not black. I'm gonna change it to something slightly lighter. Like just light gray like this. Okay. And for the text itself as well, I would like to change it to be the same color as the border color. Select this, copy, click on the text, and change the color as well. Okay, like this. Now, the next thing that I'd like to do is to select the text within this text input, select the text itself, right click on it, and then add auto layout. Now that it has been changed to an auto layout, I would like to rename it. Just to be a bit clearer, this is the text content. Okay, text wrapper. Okay, let's call it text wrapper. Now for the text wrapper, if you expand on it, you can see that the text is within the text wrapper. Now that we are selecting the text wrapper, go to the horizontal padding and change it to 4px. As for the vertical padding, I'd like you to change it to 4px as well. Okay, I know it looks a little bit weird right now. Don't worry about it. We're going to select the text wrapper and change the width to hard content, and click into the text wrapper and select the text and change it to hard content as well. And now it looks something like this. All right, cool. The next thing that we'd like to do is to select on the text wrapper and make sure that you give it a white background. Okay, click on the field to give it a white background. You'll understand why I'd like to give it a white background later. Now that you have prepared the text input, create a component by selecting the text input and click on create component over here. Once you have turned it into a component, select the text input component and click add variant on the top right. Okay, now you have something like this. Now, the next thing that we like to do is when we hover over to the text input, we would like to just turn the border color into a darker gray. So how do we do that? So we will select the second variant, variant 2, and then go to stroke and change the color to something a little bit darker like this. Okay, so this is going to be a dark gray. Right. What we're going to do is select the default variant and then click on prototype and connect the default variant to the second variant like this. The trigger, instead of on click, I would like you to change it to while hovering. Okay, now this is the first version that we have. So let's do a quick check in terms of what we have created so far. Click on the frame, draw a frame over here. I'd like you to call this frame demo. Now go to asset and search for text input. You should see your text input over here. Drag it over here and drag it inside the demo. Okay, now select the demo frame and click on flow starting point. What we like to do is to go to the presentation view, open it up in full view. Okay, let me just change it to full view like this. If I hover over, let's see what happened right now. Okay. Okay, we have some hover effect. But right now when we click on the input, nothing actually happens. So that is the next thing that we like to do. When we click on the input, this name wrapper is going to be animated up to the top. It's going to move up to the top, right? So let's see how we can do that. Let's go to our editor, click on the text input, click on the design tab over here. let's see how we do this. Okay, select any one of them is fine, but let me just select the one with hover effect, which is variant 2. And I'm going to click add variant here. Okay. Now, I'm going to do a little bit of a renaming just to make sure everything, you know, it's neat and tidy. I'd like you to select on text input, go to the default variant, which is this, click on it. You can see that over here, there is this thing called property 1. Change it and call it state. Okay. For the state, we can leave it as default state. Now, for the second one, I would like to name it and call it hover state. Okay. As for the third one, I would like to rename it and call it an active state. Oops, typo. Active state. All right. Now, for the active state, what happens is when we click on the hover effect, when we click on it, it will be switched to this text input. Right. So for this text input that is in active state, I would like to change the border color from black to perhaps, let's say, blue. Okay. I'm going to change it to blue color. All right. As for the text within the text wrapper, I will change the color as well to be the same color as the border color. So let's see what is the border color. It's this. Copy the border color, which is dark blue. Select the text. Make sure you select the text. And change it to the same color as the border color, like this. All right. Now, I would like you to select on hover and then click on prototype and connect the hover state to the active state. As for the trigger, it's going to be on click. We're going to change to the active state. Okay. Let us go to the presentation view and see what will happen. Okay. So you can see that if I hover over, there's a hover effect. If I click on it, it's going to be in an active state. But of course, we can still see that the text itself is not being animated up. So what we're going to do is we're going to create some sort of animations to move the text content up over here. Okay, let's just go back to the editor. This step is really simple. I want you to select, go to the active state text input, click on active state, and then click on the text wrapper within the active state. Once you have selected the text wrapper within the active state, you can see that there is an option called Ignore Auto Layout on the top right here. Okay, click on it. Once you have selected the Ignore Auto Layout, you can use your mouse to click on the text wrapper and just drag it up like this. Okay, you can drag it up over here like this. Okay, you can drag it up here like this. Once you have dragged it up over here, I want you to click into the name. And you can change the font size to something that is a little bit smaller. Maybe let me just change it to 10px so that the change is pronounced. Okay, when you change to 10px font size, you notice that the alignment has changed. So don't worry about it. You can always click on the text wrapper. And then just, oops, I want you to, this is the part that it gets a little bit tricky, okay? You click on the text wrapper, but make sure that your cursor is still within the text input, right? Because if you have to click outside like this, and you move it, you notice that the text wrapper is now outside of the text input, okay? You can just do a Command-Z or Control-Z to go back. Make sure that you click bottom and then just move it down like this. All right. Now, once you are done, you have something like this. We can go back to our presentation view and let's see the effect. You can press on R to restart the whole presentation view. Now, you hover over, you can see the hover effect. If you have to click on it, you can see that it has moved up like this. All right, let's look at it again. Hover effect, you click on it, the text just move it up like this. One of the common mistakes that we see over here is some students may see that the changes is too snappy, it's too instant. Where we click on it, it's just gonna, you know, instantly move up without the animations. So the thing that you need to check is if you go back to the editor, click on prototype, you can just click on these connections between the hover state and the active state. Just click on this arrow. You need to make sure that the animation is set as smart animate. Because if you don't set it as smart animate, let me just change it to instant. It will look something like this. Okay, I'm going to press R to restart it. Hover over, click on it. You can see that it's quite instantaneous. There's no animation here. Click on it, it's instant. Click on it, it's instant. Okay, but what happened is when we change it from the animation from instant to smart animate, and we go back to the presentation view, we click on it, you can see that it slowly move up like this. All right, so that's how we can create a text field with an animated label on Figma. I hope you find this video useful. If you find this video useful, give this video a thumbs up so that I know that it's actually helping you. And if you'd like to see more of such video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.